I was looking for a way to go deeper on my path. Sometimes, going deeper means flying high, as an eagle that from the top is able to see the big picture and find its perfect place. And this is the place for me now. When I arrived to the airport, I had to take a local bus, and of course I stayed like 20 minutes, almost half an hour, just to try to understand where was the bus stop, because it's not, there's no signs, no lights, nothing saying here is a bus stop. Just someone yelling and saying here, come here, and saying something that I could not understand. So basically, after a while, I came to know that there's these microbuses, very small, where everybody fits in. I don't know how many people goes inside these buses with bags and everything. It's like a miracle, everything fits inside. Even me, I'm not so tall, but I can fit there. I don't know how. And it's so crowded, but basically it takes you anywhere. It stops everywhere and it takes you wherever you want to go. You just need to understand what the bus drivers are saying. Like they say, Pokhara, 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 Pokhara. Okay, and we have to understand it goes to Pokhara. I came here 4 years ago, and at the time I just stayed a few days, just to visit, to see the landscape, which I really loved. People were really good with me, and I was very, very, very curious to know it better. And I felt very welcomed. So after 4 years, I finally came back to Nepal, thanks to SPIN NGO in Portugal that applied for EVS grant. And I'm finally doing volunteer work in one local NGO in Pokhara. And thus, all these affiliations, do they help, do they contribute for being recognized internationally or to be able to receive more funds from international donors? And this local NGO is called Alternatives and has programs for young people. Everything goes well and we do everything in our work. We go to schools, we speak with people, people come to the office and we make activities with them.
Doing what? Exactly, you know?
I'm Vasantha. After 10 years, I'm become a doctor, great doctor of Nepal.
They're going to the principal's office. Is it part of the scholarship? When they get the scholarship, you explain to their parents that they should not get married at least until they create their own jobs. Ah, okay, okay. During the day, I've made some friends here, local friends, that used to go on trekking. They enjoy a lot to go in the mountains here, which is quite a privilege because they take me sometimes to go and trekking on the hills close by. One in particular was Panchase. It was great to go up there and see all the range of mountains of Annapurna with my friends while we could sing and dance and enjoy all the beauty of the nature that was surrounding us. And also seeing the lake of Pokhara from up, up, up instead of always this ground level. It was incredible. I could even feel like being in the air very high, and I was feeling like, what about also to fly over the lake? I think it will be fantastic. Again, I saw the food, the traditional food that is dal bhat, being prepared everywhere in all Nepalese houses, with some snacks like momos also being eaten certain times. I tried anything, but this is the traditional. This is what everybody's eating. And after a while, I felt like, okay, I could adapt. I could eat every day rice and dal, but which is very healthy. But sometimes I need this fruits, pizza, and something totally different. Food is always available. You can never starve, if you have money, of course. It's on the bus. You are just sitting there, and food comes to you. You don't go to food. Food comes to you. Or you are walking in the streets, and there's the fruit sellers. When I came there the first time 4 years ago, it was very peaceful still. There was many constructions, many new houses, many services for tourists. But now, when I arrived, it was like a shock. I just saw the whole lake is surrounded by houses and businesses and cars and okay, still the nature still is there. We can still see buffaloes every day and the cows running with the children and birds, whatever kind of reptiles also there. I wanted to experience this quietness of the lake. After so many trips and so many going here, going there and working, it's so good to go by the lake, take a boat and just go in the middle and see the sunset, just enjoying the view and the calm, the peacefulness. It was riding the boat and just starting imitating all the savage animals that exist in Nepal, like tigers, I don't know, elephants, whatever, and it's really fantastic.
Uma, they come and they run away. I make many sounds.
How is the crocodile?
Crocodile, no. Crocodile, I don't know.
I came to know also that there were 5,000 NGOs at the time operating in Nepal, and I was very curious to know how was the work that they were developing, but especially a local NGO, an NGO run by Nepalese people and not so much international NGOs. And in the next day, just by chance also, it happened that in the same building of the office, I was just climbing the stairs and I met this representative from the radio, the director, and he invited me to go to make a radio interview in that same day. In the interview, he was also asking me questions about my work at Alternatives, and I had the chance to also disseminate and promote the work that my NGO is doing, my hosting organization, and also what I am doing as a volunteer in Nepal.
So what kind of work I just want to do?
Yes, we are social workers, okay. And we do dynamics with young people in order to promote entrepreneurship skills on them.
Entrepreneurship skills.
Exactly.
That means that making them independent.
Exactly.
Empowered. In the world of business.
For the poor youth who don't have money?
Yes, specifically for the disadvantaged young people living in rural areas, in villages, or even here in Pokhara, but that don't have financial possibilities to study more and to start their own businesses.
Oh.
So it means you kind of provide scholarships to them and trainings, workshops?
Exactly. Alternatives NGO is doing that. They promote and they provide these scholarships through Gaki's Like program.
Okay.
One of the things that I enjoy more of my time here in Pokhara is the Nepalese language classes.
Namaste, Sara ji.
Ramro.
Ramro.
Baini is brother, no?
No? Yeah, Baini is younger sister, now younger brother.
Younger brother.
Bhai.
Bhai.
Yes. Yes.
Dialectic. No, Shriman.
Yeah.
No, Shriman is Shrimat. So my message to all the volunteers in the world is that you should never give up. Even if things don't turn out as you think they are going to be, even if the activities are not exactly what they are written in the activity program or on the internet or on the description, that doesn't matter. You can always make a difference. You can always work with people here. It just depends on your will, on your motivation. You can learn many things from a new country, apart from the language of the culture. You can be integrated into a totally new and different society. You can learn many things about yourself. As the last thing, I really want to thank everybody that was involved in this process of for allowing me to be here to experience this. And I'm also grateful to myself that I was brave enough, I had the courage enough to come here to take this airplane and come to such a different country from mine and experience all of this, all of Nepal. And by the way, I did it.